Here is a step-by-step instruction on how to fill out the form to create a website. If you are currently a Universal Accounting student, one of your icons from the home page of uacourses.com will take you right to your website creation form. Click on My Website. As a student, some of the blanks will have the numbers filled in for you. If you currently do not have a UA Courses login, you may go to www.uasites.com and click on the Get Started Now button at the bottom of the screen. We will discuss each field in more detail. You are first asked to create a subdomain for your website. A subdomain is a web address before a parent or main address. Our parent address is uasites.com. The domain you choose is your subdomain. For example, if you choose Chuck Finley as your subdomain, your full website's domain is chuckfinley.uasites.com. Just type in the subdomain name. Do not include any www. or any .com, .net, or .ca. You will want to verify if the subdomain you have chosen is available. Click on the Check Availability button to be sure. If your subdomain has already been selected, you will be shown that it is not available, and you will need to choose a different subdomain. The next question asks if you would like to change your subdomain into a unique domain, one that does not use the .uasites.com. This can be done after the site is set up. There are some small fees associated with the change. It is not part of the free trial. By checking this box, you will be sent an email with additional information. Next, fill in your personal information. Your first name, last name, phone number, and the email that we can send your confirmation to. If you change your email later, you will be able to update this. Next, you are asked if you are a Universal Accounting student or not. If you are a current student, you need to enter your student CID. This will also be your username as you want to edit your website. If you entered with your UA Courses icon, it should transfer your number into the form. Your CID is listed at the top of your home page on UA Courses. If you do not have a student CID with Universal Accounting, choose the link showing that you are not a Universal Accounting student. The next section is often the most confusing to some students. The first field is requesting your business name. What is the name of your business? If you do not have a business name, put in your personal name. If your business is Chuck Finley Bookkeeping, I would fill the name in here. The business tagline will print just below the business name on each of your pages. It is a one-line advertisement or catchphrase about your business. It may be a specialty that you handle. It may be your title. Here is an example of where this will show. Next, you will choose your password. You will enter it twice to make sure that it was entered correctly. Make sure you choose something that you will be able to remember, but not something that is too easy to guess. The last section is the Terms of Service Agreement, the lawyer stuff. Click on the link, View the TOS Agreement by clicking here to see the agreement. This should open in a separate window or tab. Closing this tab should return you to the website form. Place a check mark in the agreement box and choose the Next Step button. That's all there is to it. Your website has been created. You should be sent a website congratulations page and be sent an email to the email from above that will give you further instructions on accessing your website. You may go back to your UA Courses homepage and you may start customizing your website from your My Websites icon. If you are not a Universal Accounting student, simply go to your domain. In the address bar after your domain, type in /admin and you'll be asked to log in using your CID and the password that you just created.